Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Today, I have an award for the ugliest workaround ever in the history of Excel. Back in episode 1016, I lamented about the fact that we cannot highlight a segment of this line chart in Excel 2003 with the surface chart because it draws a diagonal line down to the zeros. Excel 2007 doesn't do that. But I received a note from Mario. Mario's been on the podcast before, already has an Excel master pin, and clearly we need to create a new pin for this. He tells me right up front, the subject line in the email, this is an ugly, ugly solution. But check it out. This is Excel 2003, and it is only highlighting a segment of the line without the diagonals. Amazing, isn't it? All right, now, I noticed over here that we had columns D, E, F, and G were very narrow, so I went in and said, let's make these wider, and then we can see the values that are there, and sure enough, the chart includes these extra values, and if we would change the chart data back, just like my problem, it has the diagonals. So I'm going to undo that. Here is the trick. Let's take a look at these bit by bit by bit. It is brilliant. I choose Series 3, and let me change the fill color of Series 3 so you can see that those are two column charts that the background has been changed to match the Excel background. Let's take a look at Series 4. Series 4 is another column chart. We'll change the color of that to another color. And it also has been changed to match the background. That ensures that we don't get those tails appearing. What the heck is Series 5 and Series 6 for? Oh, well, hey, very clever. Series 5 and Series 6 are line charts that make sure that the line appears on top of Series 3 and Series 4. Definitely. Just this is over the top as far as going to extremes in order to make sure that, one, the grid lines reappear, two, those rogue columns, because there's always someone who has some amazing way to do it. Now, if I had to do this day after day after day, I would probably just throw down the money to get Excel 2007 and deal with the ribbon. A very, very cool way to go. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.